Thank you, Commissioner, for your service. Can you, I want to just echo my colleague's comments on design build, and hopefully that is negotiated without a problem in the budget so that the city can have it also. I represent Queen, so just wanted to ask you about the Kew Gardens interchange. You said there's another $564 million to be invested in the Kew Gardens interchange. Can you tell me if that will finally resolve the problem of the water that is continuing to still pond when you go northbound on the Van Wick towards the Grand Central?
We think it's going to make a significant impact. As I mentioned, there'll be an additional lane in either direction, managed lane, which will help. It's proven to work elsewhere. But in combination, you know, with what wayfinding signs and the work that's being done at the airport as well, there's a traffic plan which we're not involved in, you know, for the airport proper. All of those things should help the flows.
Well, I meant there's still a water flow problem from the high water table in that area, and there's still water that actually stays on the roadway.
Can you tell me how water is being discharged?
Have they figured it out?
Drainage is all part of the program as well, and I neglected to mention that. Drainage is part of the project with the road reconstruction, adding the lanes. There's another benefit that I didn't mention that I want to. You know, we believe that, as you know now, some of the neighborhoods that are close to the highway, if you will, are severely impacted with traffic that goes right by their front door.
Right.
So in terms of, you know, air quality, emissions, kind of a healthier environment for people, we believe this is really going to help get people back on that road where they should be, away from people's front door and back on the highway. But drainage is a big part of that, too. And, of course, that'll help with some of the ponding issues that I know are experienced with some of the neighbors also.
Okay. Well, there's ponding issues on the streets, and I appreciate the beautification that's being done, especially along the Queens Boulevard area with creating a mall for sitting that hopefully they'll be putting a lot of trees up there also.
Mm-hmm.
But there's still a ponding on the actual Van Wick roadway itself. I know it's been a difficult problem. It's been there for decades. I hope that discharge, that they can figure it out, because it seems to be a real difficult problem with the water that's there from Flushing Meadow Park, and trying to figure out how that drain will be significantly eradicated. I know is a problem. I would hope that the money is, that we're not spending all that money and we still have that ponding at the end of the day. The Kew Gardens interchange and also the access to the airport. Did you mention, or did I miss it in your question or in your statement, that there was a feasibility study to see if there'll be another opportunity to develop a one ride to the airport from Midtown Manhattan?
That, I believe that's with the Port Authority, or is it with the end of the Port Authority?
Will DOT have a role in it at all?
No.
Okay. And then also I wanted to ask you about the pavement, the quality of the pavement, because it seems like every year that the roadway has to get repaired, the Long Island Expressway and the Van Wick. You know, I know it's the two of the heaviest roadways in the country as far as usage is concerned. But it seems like every 6 months it just falls apart right after the winter season, or sometimes even during the season. Has there been any new materials that have been developed that could make a better pavement?
We have a laboratory. We're mandated to have a laboratory by the federal government. And they're constantly looking for ways, short of concrete, how we can have a better mix that will hold up better, if you will.
Mm-hmm.
The challenges simply are, you know, you come from hot weather, you go to cold weather, the freezing thawing, and then the reality is there's just an enormous amount of traffic that's almost 24/7 on those roadways.
Right.
And it's a constant battle, there's no doubt about it. But yeah, the labs are always looking at how we can improve you know, kind of the strength, if you will, of our asphalt mixes and other materials.
Okay, but nothing's been developed yet that you could say could be tested or brought into that area?
Not to my knowledge. One of the things that we're looking at that I wouldn't recommend there, though, would be, you know, kind of porous pavements. Those are utilized better in different areas where we can utilize the roadway to remove water away from identified water bodies.
Right.
So we're doing that type of work. I wouldn't recommend it there just by simply of the volumes. But no, is the honest answer. At this point, those are the materials that we're using, but we're constantly looking to build a better mousetrap.
And you mentioned earlier also the Diesel Emissions Reduction Act. Are we fully ready to implement that full plan, or will there need to be another delay? No, the Diesel Emissions Reduction.
Not at this time, but we are making great progress in changing over our fleet. But I wouldn't commit here today that, you know, we were ready completely to be done with that.
What about the requirements that contractors and other people that are working on state projects also have their fleet upgraded? Where are we with that process?
We continue to work with the GCA, number of different construction industry professionals across the board for that as well.
All right. Thank you, Commissioner.
And I will also follow up on the water issue for you. We'll get back to
you. Yes, I'll follow back on that, because that is part of my district, and I do get a lot of concerns. I've had two residents in the last month that actually spun out in that intersection.
Okay. I'm happy to do that.
All right. Thank you.